Yeah, I'm a little late to the party, but better late than never, considering that this is a Marvel trailer, it's practically everywhere, and eventually I was gonna get exposed to it off camera or off stream. But here I am, without having ever watched it, the new teaser trailer for Eternals, which was bound to come across sooner or later after that commemorative, welcoming back the movies video that Marvel did that was mostly there to showcase Phase 4. But we caught really quick shots and glimpses at the Eternals movie, the newest movie from Chloé Zhao, first Oscar-winning director to helm a Marvel movie. So that's already a selling point all on its own. It's also the cast that's got me thoroughly intrigued, but never really knew who the Eternals were, didn't know any of the backstory, didn't know the lore. But hey, Guardians of the Galaxy was that strange anomaly. Let's hope that maybe Eternals could be the same way. So let's check out the trailer. Let's go. Already hitting us with the visuals. Oh yeah, it's already no. It's definitely looking like Nomadland. Definitely a closed down movie. Eternals are like, we come to fuck shit up.
Speedphone. Listener.
Good transition.
We have watched. Unguided. We have helped them progress. And seen them accomplish wonders.
Sounds like she's reciting Jor-El.
We have never interfered until now.
Oh, that guy.
Thank you for this.
Oh, you're welcome.
So now that Captain Rogers and Iron Man are both gone, who do you think's gonna lead the Avengers?
I could lead them.
Okay. So notice that minus my couple of commentaries there at the beginning, didn't really have much to say. And that could be seen as maybe a thing that I'll just be full and fully transparent from the get-go, is that the movie looks gorgeous visually as far as capturing how their powers work, the diversity of their powers, seeing some of the shots here, because in the beginning here you can see how they're arriving, and that was the whole premise of the movie from the get-go, that Kevin Feige, Chloe Zhao made it clear, is that these are extraterrestrial beings pretty much coming in to Earth way back, like we're talking 10,000 BC sort of a time era, and you can kind of see that kind of start to occur here.
Speedphone.
The Richard Madden and her, who she's making the rounds right now because a lot of people find it interesting that she's actually gotten double casted. It's not the first time it's happened, but it's probably the most prolific sense where it's like a lead actress in one Marvel movie, even though she's already been in another Marvel movie as a different character, but her past, the past that she gets is that in that other movie she was wearing a heavy amount of makeup. I can't remember her character's name. It's like a normal name, but it's spaced out in the middle, but she's in Captain Marvel. She's the girl with the blue skin as one of the mercenaries that is under Jude Law's character's, kind of command. She was in that. And now here, she's playing a different character, but in the lead capacity. So like I said, we've seen that this kind of double dipping with casting before, like the actress Alfre Woodard, who played Black Maria in Luke Cage, but she was also in that really small cameo kind of role in Civil War as a different character. But here, it's just a bit more prolific, you know what I mean? It's in the bigger scale. From that point on, then we do get, like I said, cool manifestation of the people's powers. Great costume design. I can already see a potential Oscar nomination for costume design, as far as like how everything looks, as far as how the technology of these eternal beings works with the way that then Earth kind of just goes through the notions of history. You know, even her narration, she says that, you know, we've seen them accomplish wonders. We kind of just kind of chilled in the background, watching the knowledge, watching things unfold. But something causes them to interfere. Okay. With that said, I know it's just a teaser. But I'm scared that this might look boring. Or might be boring. Because something that really works with worked with Guardians of the Galaxy is obviously the humor, which was there from the very beginning, from the very first trailer to the premiere of the movie. They sold us on the humor. The inclusion of a talking tree and a talking raccoon mixed in with a human and then two other alien beings. You know that shit can go awry. And they're outcasts, you know, they're all outcasts in their own kind of ecosphere, their own kind of system, their species or whatever, and that's what made them that family that they become at the end of the movie. But we got that vibe from the trailer. Here, I know that they're all gods to a degree. I know I could very well be surprised. Guardians of the Galaxy was one of the biggest surprises of the MCU to this date. Right now, I don't see anything that surprises me. I'm probably in the minority in saying this, that I just don't get excited by this Eternals trailer. I'm loving what I'm seeing as far as visuals with, like I said, the costume and how they manifest their powers. Especially with that cool sword right there. You can definitely tell that these two are going to have a romance over the years. Kumail Nanjiani. He looks amazing, quite literally, because whatever he's taking, I want it. And also, I'm loving the Bollywood influence here. And that kid, I feel like that kid has potential to steal the show. I know, like I said, very tough to tell from a trailer. Huge ensemble cast with great talent. But I'm just not seeing that hook.
Thank you for that.
I mean, here, I get a sliver of that where they're not only self-aware and they acknowledge that this is taking place after Endgame.
Now that Captain Rogers and Iron Man are both gone, who do you think's gonna lead the Avengers?
I could lead them.
Okay. So at least we get that end scene right there to kind of make us, kind of give them that family ambiance or whatever. But the fact that they're all gods and not outcasts, they all look to be on that same kind of platform. I don't know. It's only a teaser trailer. I definitely want to see a second trailer because right now as it is, looks interesting, but I'm way more hyped, obviously, for Black Widow, for goddamn even Loki. And most definitely for Spider-Man than I really am for this. But the MCU has known to surprise before. Could happen again. That's just my take. Let me know what you guys think in the comments. Let me know what you guys expect for Eternals to kind of accomplish as far as the grand scheme of things. And I shall see you guys on the next one. Take care.